How are you? That's the first question.
I'm fine.
Okay.
I've accepted the situation and my fate, and we move on. I have so many advocacies, and I think I'll still continue with that.
Okay. Do you think you were treated fairly by the Commission on Appointments?
Well, whether it's fair or not, I think that's beside the point. It's what's constitutionally required, then we undergo the process.
Okay. They've raised some points in the Commission on Appointments hearing, which I believe you may want to clear your name over some of these points, which were integral in essentially the rejection. And I'll start with this. We'll start first with Philhealth, wherein there was a petition coming from 150 employees that wanted you out as DOH secretary. A Philhealth employee actually filed charges against you and said, accused you of grave abuse of power and usurpation of authorities, that you suspended their allowances, and you, I think, didn't give the salary adjustments, if at all. What was the truth there?
The truth there is that I think it's been also raised in that particular CA hearing that the work of the chairman of the board is to preside board meetings, and all decisions, all actions of the health secretary pertains to that role. And if we suspended the giving of benefits that were actually disallowed already by the Commission on Audit and was not allowed by the GCG, the Governance Council. So the role of the Health Secretary is chairperson of the board.
Uh-oh. You were one vote?
Yes. It's a collegial body. Uh-oh. So it's the decision of the board, not mine alone.
Okay. So do you believe then that was, I mean, clearly was there misinformation? Because do you think the CA didn't consider that you're just a member of the board?
I'm sure there was misinformation, particularly for those 150 employees, because the PhilHealth Employees Association, headed by the president, Mrs. S.P. Ocampo, Esperanza Ocampo, was there and supporting me.
Okay.
Because they understood what's happening, and it's beyond the control of the board.
Okay, but another issue in PhilHealth is no less than the PhilHealth president and CEO, Mr. Dineros, claims that you were peddling lies and that he claims he didn't resign, but that you removed him from his post. So what is the truth?
So I'm really, really disappointed in Dr. Dineros. What is his proof that I lied? What is his proof that he did not resign? I have with me the minutes of the meeting. I have a video recording of that executive session. I have the board resolution that he resigned, and the board accepted his resignation. So I don't know, maybe his definition of resign and ousted is different from my definition.
Did you manipulate the board into removing him from his post?
Of course not. Okay. Of course not. I never did that for PhilHealth. I can never do that in any position in government. I don't manipulate. I just try to work hard and be honest.
Uh-oh.
Now, I have with me affidavits, because the petition was filed, I think, 4 o'clock the other day. So only two of the board members I have with me. But the nine other board members who were there at that particular executive session where he resigned, signed petitions to actually say they were never approached by me, and I never manipulated the results of that executive session.
Were any of the members of the board in PhilHealth, did they attend the CA hearing to at least defend you? They did.
Yes,
okay.
They were there.
So if this is the case, you're telling me that it's a case of misinformation, do you believe that there was a conscientious effort to remove you then as DOH secretary coming from sectors in PhilHealth?
That I am certain,
okay.
Karen.
Who wants you out in PhilHealth?
I don't know, but I'm certain there is a calculated effort to remove me as DOH Secretary and as Chairperson of the Board of PhilHealth. Calculated.
Okay. Did you make a mistake in appointing a new PhilHealth CEO, and is that within your jurisdiction? Because you have a CA member saying that only the president can do that.
Excuse me. I think that's also one thing that I have to clear. It is not my responsibility and it is not my decision to actually remove a sitting interim president and CEO or put somebody in.
Mm-mm.
No, it is a board decision.
Mm-mm.
And well, of course, when we appointed the previous interim CEO, it is with full trust and confidence that we appoint him, that he is qualified for the position. But in the course of his doing his duty and responsibilities, he actually went against a directive of the board. How can we not remove him for loss of trust and confidence? So we did. We removed him. And we filed cases with the ombudsman and with other oversight committees based on the infractions of the previous.
Mm-mm.
Then a new one comes in and he does the same. So we lose trust and confidence. So I don't know why all the blame is on me when I am just one vote in the board.
Because perhaps they feel that you lead the board.
Yes, I lead the board, but I don't dictate on the board. I preside over the meetings and we make a decision. It's collegial. If the board doesn't want that to happen, I cannot do anything about that.
Looking back, should you have made an effort to actually speak to the people concerned so they wouldn't have this misimpression about you, so to speak?
We have a communication bureau in unit in PhilHealth, and they make the communication plan to the staff, to the public, and I think it was adequately communicated. But I believe that there was a lot of, shall we say, destabilization and disinformation from among the ranks of PhilHealth, because they felt that I was manipulative. I was trying to control PhilHealth, but I did not.
Okay.